everybody, Cristina Lynn here with Cristina Lynn's Inn. I hope you're having a blessed and beautiful day. I wanted to come to you today with just a short practice of finding your breath, setting an intention of something positive, and moving through some fascia tissue opening, as well as speaking to a few poses for today. So grab your mat, find a great place that brings you peace, whether that's inside or outside, and let's get started. We're going to begin in mountain pose. Our feet are going to be hip distance apart. You're going to focus on planting the four corners of the feet into your mat, lifting the arches of your feet, lifting the kneecaps into the quadriceps muscles, lifting the belly button and drawing it into the spine, dropping the tailbone, bringing the hands down to the side. We're going to inhale deeply up through our nose. Good cleansing breath as you find your arms down as we come into mountain pose, Tadasana pose. Feel the strength here, and let's take a couple of more cleansing breaths just right here. If you feel safe and you feel secure, go ahead and close your eyes and just feel the breath. Inhaling through the nose, filling up the lungs, and sighing it out through the mouth. One more big cleansing breath right here. Inhaling through the nose. Sighing it out. Now feel the power from the bottoms of the feet all the way through the top of the head. Inhaling through the nose this time. And exhaling deeply through the nose, drawing the belly button into your spine. Inhaling deeply through the nose. Exhaling deeply through the nose, drawing the belly button to the spine. While you're falling into this pranayama, I want you to think about an intention for your practice and for the rest of the day. It could be that you're working on one particular word. It could be that you have a prayer for either yourself or someone that you know and love. Today, mine has been embracing and finding gratitude even in the uncomfortable places that life tends to bring us sometimes. Inhaling deeply through the nose. Exhaling deeply through the nose. And while we are here in mountain pose, and as we move on our mats the remainder of this practice, I challenge you to focus on this breath, and I challenge you to focus on this intention. Carry this with you through your practice. Carry this with you throughout your daily walk. One more round of breathing right here in mountain pose. Smiling at yourself because you made it to the mat. Beautifully done. Let's open our feet up a little wider than hip distance apart. We are going to open up the hip joints. So I want you to drop that right hip out to the right, and I want you to circle your hips back and around, popping that left hip out to the left, circling the hips forward and around. And while we're opening up our hips, let's remember to breathe. Inhaling and exhaling. And smile. Inhaling and exhaling. And once we feel satisfied with one direction, let's go in the opposite direction. Being mindful of the belly button drawing into the spine. Being mindful that the knees aren't locked out. Checking in with those hip joints. And once we feel satisfied with both directions, we're going to bring our feet hip distance apart. We're going to plant the left foot all four corners down, come up onto the toe joints of the right foot, and press down hard into the mat. Press, and then I want you to rotate that ankle, opening up that ankle joint, welcoming new blood flow to that joint. Once you feel satisfied with one direction, I want you to take it into the opposite direction. The whole idea here is to open up the connective tissue to send new blood flow to the joints that we're working on. And once you feel satisfied with both directions, I want you to take those knuckle joints again and press them into the mat. And then just give it a good shake. Plant that right foot into the mat. Coming up onto the toe joints, the knuckle joints of the left foot. Begin rotating, pressing those joints into the mat, rotating that ankle one way, and then rotating it the opposite direction. And then pressing that toe joint back down into the mat and then giving it a good shake. We're going to then stand feet hip distance apart, and we're going to open up those shoulders, open up that heart center. Start small with the shoulder circles, and then as you feel confident, let's add some extra rotation in there, being mindful of your shoulders. You can add the arms in if you'd like, add a smile in if you'd like. And then once you feel satisfied in one direction, let's start out small, going in the opposite direction. Opening up that heart joint, opening up the back. Allowing the arms to flow and move. Waking up those shoulder joints, welcoming new blood flow. And once you feel satisfied in both directions, let's bring our hands up, kind of wake them up a little, the hands and the wrists. Let's make some fists with our hands and pop those fingers open just to bring the blood flow to the fingers. I know some of us struggle with arthritis issues. This is a great way to help welcome that new blood flow and chase out the stagnant blood that's been hanging out in there. Move those wrists around like you're directing, or maybe like you're flying, whatever you like to think of it as. And then once you feel comfortable with both wrists, just kind of shake them out. Welcome the blood flow. Feet are still hip distance apart. We're going to work our neck next. So make sure your chin is horizontal with the floor, with the mat. You're going to inhale, and as you exhale, you're going to look to the right shoulder, being mindful not to overstretch the neck. You're going to inhale back to the center, and exhale to the left shoulder. Inhaling to center, exhaling to the right, inhaling to center, exhaling to the left. One more time on each side. I love the birds. Love the wind. Coming back to center, we're going to inhale. And as we exhale, we're going to drop our chins gently, very gently down to our chest. Being mindful of the neck. Inhaling back to center. And when you look up, I want you to stretch that neck, that chin up to work that thyroid gland. Inhaling back to center. Exhaling through the nose, chin to chest. Inhaling back to center. Exhaling, reaching up with the chin. A couple more rounds of your own time. one more chin to chest. One more to look up and stretch that thyroid gland. Inhaling back to center and then shaking out the entire body. Hello, blood flow. Let's find our mountain pose one more time. Again, the four corners of the feet are finding the mat. They're finding stability, they're finding security. You're lifting those toes and spreading them wide, lifting the arches, lifting the kneecaps up into the quadricep muscles, tightening. You feel the strength in just the bottom portion of your body. Tuck that tailbone under to activate the glutes, activate the abdominal region. Inhale the arms up. Exhaling. As you activate those arms from the shoulder joints all the way down through the fingers, this is activating the traps, the lats, and the rhomboids all the way down the back. You should feel power, you should feel confidence, you should feel security and safety right here in mountain pose, Tadasana. Close your eyes and just embrace the power. If you're swaying a little and you feel more comfortable, open the eyes very gently and just cast your gaze downward, relaxing the face. Inhaling through the nose, exhaling and drawing that belly button into the spine. Inhaling through the nose. Exhaling through the nose. Feel the power. Feel the light generating from your core out. Inhaling one more time here in mountain pose. Exhaling deeply through the nose. Fluttering your eyes open. If you shut them, we're going to inhale and go into warrior one. Inhaling. And with that left foot, I want you to step back. Finding warrior one. Inhaling and exhaling, checking in with that back left foot. Four corners of that foot should be planted into the mat. Drawing that kneecap up into the quads. Drawing that inner thigh up and around back into the glutes. Checking in with the hips. They should be facing the front of your mat like a set of headlights. Checking in with that right front knee. It should be over the right ankle. You should be able to look down and see the big toe. Lots of power in warrior one, Virabhadrasana one. Smiling, feeling the power. Inhaling deeply through the nose. Exhaling deeper and drawing that belly button in. Inhaling, the arms should be activated and beside the ears, the shoulders should be down and away from our ears. One more round of breath right here in warrior one. Inhaling, exhaling. We're going to inhale, and as we exhale, we're going to step up back into mountain pose. What happens on the left must happen on the right. Finding mountain pose again. One round of breath right here. Inhaling through the nose deeply. Exhaling and drawing that belly button into the spine. Inhaling. And with this exhale, I want you to take that right foot back. Finding that 45 degree angle with that back right foot. Four corners of that right foot are planted into the mat. The kneecap is drawing up and in to the quadricep muscle. The inner thigh muscle is wrapping up and back around towards the glutes. Check in with your hips. They should be facing the front of your mat like a set of headlights. That front left
knee should be over the left ankle, and when you look down, you should be able to see the left toes, the big toe at least. The arms are nice and firmly activated, and the shoulders are down and away from the ears. Inhaling, exhaling. Feel the power in Warrior One, Virabhadrasana One. Inhaling, exhaling. Inhale here, and then you exhale, come back up into Warrior One. Finding Mountain Pose, we're going to prepare our minds for Warrior Two. Inhaling through the nose deeply, exhaling deeper through the nose, drawing that belly button in, working that core, inhaling deeply. And as we exhale, step that left foot back. Right foot is forward. The right heel, the front foot, is in line with the back left arch. Take a look at that left leg. Draw that kneecap up into the quadricep muscles. That inner thigh should come up and wrap up towards the glutes. Check in with your hips. They should be squared off with the side of your mat. We're going to inhale. And as we exhale, we're going to come deeper into our Warrior Two pose. The arms are activated. The neck is relaxed. Always. Looking over that right hand, that right fingertip. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling. And as you exhale, I want you to come back up into Mountain Pose. Again, what happens on one side must happen on the other. Finding Mountain Pose. One round of breath right here. Smiling. Inhaling, and as you exhale, step that right foot back into Warrior Two. Check in with that back right foot. The arch should be in line with the front left foot heel. Drawing that kneecap up into the quadricep muscle, wrapping that inner thigh muscle up and back into the glutes. Checking in with the hips. If I set a bowl of water in your pelvic zone, it wouldn't spill. Keeping that horizontal with the mat, with the floor. We're going to inhale, and as we exhale, we're going to come deeper into our Warrior Two pose. When you look down, that front knee should be over the ankle. You should be able to see the big toe. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling, exhaling, feeling the confidence, feeling the power, exhaling. One more round here. And as you exhale, come back up into Mountain Pose, Tadasana. Smiling. We're going to put those together. We're going to go from Warrior One to Warrior Two on each side. Mountain Pose, one round of breath right here. Feel the energy, feel the strength and security. Inhaling, exhaling. Inhaling deeply. And as you exhale, step that left foot back into Warrior One pose. Inhaling. Exhaling. If this bothers the neck, you can bring your arms down into airplane arms or goalpost arms. Inhaling and exhaling. One more round and then we're going to Warrior Two. Inhaling. Exhaling. exhaling, inhaling, and on the exhale, find your warrior two pose. Find that confidence, feel that power, inhaling and exhaling, inhaling and exhaling. One more round, inhaling, exhaling, inhaling, and let's step back up into mountain pose. One round of breath right here in mountain, inhaling. Inhaling. And as you step that right foot back into warrior one pose, find that power. Check in with those hips. They should be squared off with the front of your mat. Couple rounds of breath right here, feeling the confidence. Again, being mindful of the neck. We need to go airplane arms or goalpost arms. Whatever serves your body today. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling, smiling, exhaling. Inhaling, and let's find our way into warrior two pose. Again, feeling the confidence, feeling your strength building. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling, exhaling, one more big inhale, and as you exhale, find your way back up into mountain pose. One more round of breath right here in mountain, exhaling. You want to find a comfortable place to lie down. If you're protecting your back, then you want to leave your feet wider than hip distance apart. You want your knees to fall together. Allow the weight of the knees to fall together. The arms will be away from the body, the palms facing up to receive blessings of good energy. If your back feels okay, then go ahead and stretch your feet out. Allow them to fall open so that your inner thighs can face the ceiling, or in my case, the big beautiful sky. The sun feels amazing. Drawing the shoulders down and away from the ears. Feel the heaviness of your body. Allow your body to be heavy from the core up and down the left side of your body. Feel the weight, feel the gravity pull on that left side. Closing your eyes, smiling. And then allow the heaviness, allow the weight of the body to pull on the right side. Even more heaviness throughout the body. Finding peace here in Shavasana, in restoration pose. Take a big deep breath in through the nose. Big cleansing breath. One more cleansing breath, inhale. And then repeat.
return to normal breathing. Shavasana is a great time to reflect on that intention. It's a great time to say a prayer. You can hear the birds. You can hear that bit of wind. Allow your body to relax. Feel the heaviness. Guide your way on. May the long time sun shine upon you. All love surround you and the pure light within you. Guide your way on. Stay here in Shavasana as long as your body needs. May we always see, may we always speak, and may we always feel love and compassion for ourselves and towards ourselves and for others and towards others. The light in me honors the blessed and beautiful light that burns deep within each of you. Namaste.